Greetings, fam. Greetings. Greetings once again. Happy Saturday. This is Saturday, Reparations Saturday School, where we talked about our spiritual, getting our spiritual house in order so we can build on that, make that our foundation. First of all, we want to give honor to God, the great I am, the head of our life. Before anything starts, we honor God. And we honor God even when we don't say it, because every breath we take is honoring God. Believe that. Believe that. Don't take a breath and see what happens. Right? The breath of life. The breath of life. So, this is going to be a brief one today. I want us to get focused. I want us to settle down. Take some time for ourselves in order to think and meditate. And the only way you can grow is that you have to spend time. You can't be so busy trying to multitask and do all these things. There's no such thing as multitasking, because you can only do one task at a time. All right? Anything else, you're tricking yourself. So you want to focus on what you do, so that way you do it correctly. So you put your, then you move on to the next thing. You can line it up. That's what you got, your things to do list. So you can line your tasks up. But you spend time on it. You might want to get the easiest task first and build and work on that. But you can only do one thing at a time. You only do one thing at a time. You try to do too many things at one time, you end up locking your keys in the car, right? Peace and blessings to you. I hope you begin to understand how powerful this three-tier ministry is. The Temple of Inner Peace and Prosperity, which is self. Our university and the home, Boardwalk School of Economics, that teaches us and our children to compete, and we want to build a legacy. In the next coming weeks, we talked about spirituality for quite some time, so we're going to start talking about estate planning and building wealth by getting our house in order. We need to concentrate on making sure we have children, we have our wills in place, we have our trust, living trust, our asset protection. Then we're going to go into our businesses. And we're going to start having guest speakers to come on board that talk about their businesses. I have some Facebook groups that we reached out to each other and start having guests. And if you have a special project or you want to become a guest, that will become available to you as well. All right. So today is, what must you do to become even greater? So we're very talented people. We have big egos, right? And we don't want nobody telling us what to do. But sometimes we have to listen to others in order to get that wisdom. That's a wise person that can learn from others. A smart person is going to figure it out for themselves, end up. That's why it takes 10, 15, 20 years to finish a project that never gets going. See, but a wise person can learn from others, a professional, a mentor that can help you in these areas. So what must you do to become even great? First of all, complete the orientation program. Go through the website, list it right there. Spend some time, meditation time. Treat this like a regular university in your home series. Then you must become a leader, right? Complete the orientation, get your spiritual foundation in order, because we want kind, loving people to be a part of this movement and wealth creation. See? And there's a method to the madness here. So just humble yourself and just spend a short period of time and you will see what I'm talking about. First, you must become a leader. Not a leader of others, but first a leader of your own self. A leader of yourself. Self-disciplined and determined to be the best person that you can be. This requires the proper training and skill development. As young as possible, a person must realize that they only have one life, and that life should not be wasted. In addition to developing and maximizing your inner self and developing your talents, the more people that you can surround yourself who share your passion and determination to live their best life, the better off you will become through this short journey called your life. As a minister and professional, my mission and passion is to help you and yours to maximize your life purpose by helping you to discover it. Progress takes place in an environment of peace and tranquility. This is why I've spent so much time on the spiritual part of this ministry, in personal growth and professional development. How do you eat a steak? One bite at a time. My goal is to help you to discover your inner strength by showing you how to take back your power. We spend too much time on outer stimulation versus inner meditation and personal development. Let me help you to lay a foundation so our next generation can have a brighter future and better days ahead for all of us who desire it. It is important to make your children feel they are part of your life and have worth independent of you as their parents. This is a mental health issue. How do we empower our children? And I created the 52-week wealth training workshop, family workshop, for this particular purpose. We want them to see a future of opportunities and not obstacles, expecting that they will not be able to live a fulfilled life. Right now, our children are in despair. They cannot see a bright future for themselves, especially the ones that are growing up in the inner city today. And we must do better. We must understand and then overstand. A lot of us want to use the word overstand, but in order to overstand, you must first understand. You can't come into something unless you know what's going on first. You can't understand. You can't overstand unless you understand. That we must stop worshiping images and individuals outside of ourselves besides the one true God who gave us a roadmap to his kingdom. We worship false idols, images, entertainers, athletes. We spend more time worrying about what they're doing in their life than understanding about our own destiny and what our purpose is. You need to focus on you and what your expectations in life and what God expects of you. God gave us a kingdom to practice with. He gave us our own kingdom, right? That we could develop into a heaven or a hell. This kingdom is inside all of us. This is where free will comes into play. People want to blame it on the devil and the Satan. He can't do anything to you unless you let him. Unless you let him. And even if it does, you have to stand fast. Just like in the book of Job, he stood fast. And the whole objective is to take back your power. Turn your face back to God. And cut this idol worship out that gets into your head. And it distracts you from your true purpose. We live in an ever-changing society, and as a larger community, we're not being properly prepared because we do not understand how the game of economic life requires us working together. That's how immigrants come to our community and prosper. They can educate their kids, they can buy homes, because they're working together. Besides us financing their life, the kids become, grow up, go to college, they become our boss and treat us with disrespect and look at us like, what's wrong with these people? And rightly so. We are retiring now after spending an entire life grinding it out. Many of us are not prepared, but only because we continue to fail each other. This is a team sport. Listen to my previous and future messages. These are truly blessings to empowerment, free of charge. Let me help. While on this journey to inspire and encourage you to change your ways for the better, let me teach you how to become your best self. Then we can practice what we have been learning in the spirit of unity together. But we have to all be on the same page. It is not a difficult thing to ask of you. A house divided among itself is weak and cannot stand for anything. Look at our homes, relationships, and communities. But yet we blame racism and institutional oppression when we have the power to change these circumstances ourselves. We want everybody to do for us when we have the power to do for ourselves. We give it too much power. I can teach you to take back your power and see yourself as a new creature of glory and substance. Check out the previous messages. Once we start dreaming and loving each other, we can accomplish miracles. This is my mission statement: to restore lives and empower communities. Dr. Martin Luther King gave us the vision of equality. Now is the time to grab for it, because it is never freely given. As a household and as a community, we have the ability and resources because we are very talented people. Very talented. God gave us, He gave it to us. We got the talent. However, do we possess the desire, dedication, and determination to make this vision of equality and prosperity manifest itself? See, we used to the secret and understand that the universe is full of abundance, but we have to do something to gather the abundance. We need to do it right here and right now. I too can see the promised land, but it requires our combined efforts to get there. This is a spiritual, educational, and economic ministry. Make this your ministry. The Temple of Inner Peace and Prosperity. You are the temple, and it teaches you how to gain inner peace and prosperity. You must be willing to see a different reality in order to manifest a different reality. As a community, our wheels have fallen off. Let's put them back on by learning to work together as a team. There is unlimited wealth and power through unity. Believe that. It's a formula. It's math. It's just basic math. Teamwork indeed makes the dream work. Remember, we are our brothers and sisters' keepers. And it takes a village. It's more than just a mere cliche. Get ready and stay ready. The choice is yours. Jesus said, I came that you may have life. Life. And live life more abundantly. That's what this message is about. That's what this ministry is about. Get ready. Stay ready. The choice is yours. The doors of the Temple of Inner Peace and Prosperity is always open 24/7. And this is therapy. This is therapy. You have to learn to spend time with yourself and meditate and stop letting other people in your head. You have to be your own therapist, and we can get together. Sometimes it's good to hear different thoughts and perspectives. But if you take the time to quiet time and pray about it, believe me, God will give you the answers. You are your own blessing. But you have to put some work in, my friends. You need to put some work in. And by working together, we can have fun together and build together. It'll be a beautiful thing. Just believe me. Take some time. Please like and share and comment. Let me know what's on your mind. Let me know what's on your mind. The doors of the temple are open 24/7. And make this ministry of yours, the Temple of Inner Peace and Prosperity, Boardwalk School of Economics, and our Business and Legal Department. This is a powerful combination to help you to be the best person that you can be. Be more and thrive. The Reverend Dr. Claude A. Sinclair, at your service. At your service.